Hello, everybody. Again, this is Timmy-Fan, and this is the last portion of my diary about my move. Well, to continue from what I was talking about yesterday, after moving out of Patty's house, you know, I was scared to death because I thought Ma was upset with me for getting kicked out of there. But after I told her what happened, and after she met Patty's brother, she realized that wasn't the right place for me because she sensed that her brother was something of a bully too, not just Patty. So I was glad to be out of there. She was glad I was out of there. And I didn't really want to go to her place again, but I had no choice. It was either that or go to my father's, and my father's girlfriend and I apparently don't get along. Her choice, not mine. Anyway, I went back to my ma's. The dogs went back to the people who took care of them before. And I was upset because I had to let go of my dogs again. And it's not that I didn't think the dogs would be taken care of at all, because those people took real good care of them. Kind of overdid it with the treats as far as Vegas went, but they took care of them for the most part, and it was a place for them to stay, and they were nice people. So I had to take the dogs back there, but I was so upset about letting them go that I just cried for days. You know, it's like letting go of your children. Those are the only children I have and I'll ever know. So letting them go it tore me apart. So I moved back in with Ma, and the night after I had moved back in, my stepfather was all over me, talking about how I'm wasting electricity and how I was leaving the lamps on in the living room and all that stuff. And I was like, well, I'm going back in there. He just kept going on and on about that. And, you know, I don't think he meant it to be hurtful. You know, it's just that I was so vulnerable at that time. I was missing my babies. I didn't have them with me. I couldn't find comfort in them. So it wasn't so much that he was on my case. It's just that all these things happening at once and his getting on my case was just like the straw that broke the camel's back, you know, and I just started bawling again. I was just missing my dogs. That was all. Anyways, I thought I had hit my lowest point. I think spending that 4 days with the dogs probably did me much more harm than good. It just made me miss them more when I had to take them back. To you people that just don't understand how I felt, try having something of yours taken away and you having to live without it. That's how I felt. For a month. Actually, 2 months. Because I moved to Ma's in September. And I just got this place. Sorry, Ma and John. You guys are great. I love you to death. But living with you is not my style. I thought I had hit my lowest point. So I kept looking and looking and looking in earnest for a place to live. Well, about 2 weeks after I moved into Ma and John's apartment, I found this place on Craigslist. And it was a rent-to-own type deal. I pay so much for this place a month, and it goes into the price of this home. Now, this is an RV. Well, it's not an RV. It's a camper trailer. It doesn't have a motor or anything. It's just a camper trailer. And I've always wanted to know what it's like to live in one of these. Well, at least for the next 3 years, I'm going to find out. So I kind of hit it pretty big with this. If I don't like it at the end of the 3 years, I can sell it Or maybe during the 3 years, I can pass this off to somebody else. My sister said she wants it if I don't. I told her, you know, that when the time comes, she knows what I'm talking about. I can give this place to her, I think. I could let her take over the contract, and she can have this trailer. It's not a huge RV. I wish it was, but it's a cute little 35-foot trailer. And for me, this is all I really need. I don't need a big apartment. I don't need a big house. All I need is a place to crash at night and to cook my dinner during the day and clean myself when I need it, which is sometimes several times a day, depending on how hard I work. And I'm able to keep my dogs. I got my babies back with me, so I'm happy. I'm very happy. I don't ever have to look at Patty again. I don't ever have to look at her ugly mug again. I don't have to live with Ma and John anymore. And my dogs can stay with me. I'm happy. This is all I wanted. But it's a nice place. It's a cute little trailer. And I will spend the last half of this video showing you what it's like. Okay, now I'm going to give you a rundown of this place that I moved into, my RV. Ignore the mess. I'm still in the process of moving in and cleaning up. So this basically is my bedroom. Not much space around the bed, as you can tell. There's the dog's new blanket. There's their dish. And here's my door. And we go down the hall. This is my kitchen. And this is my dining room. Sort of. I use it as a computer room. And here's the bathroom. Blah, blah, blah. Here's my curtain that I got since I moved here. Bathtub. Actually, it's a shower. I use it as a shower only. And this is the back room where I store all my things. That's kind of unsafe, so I don't let the dogs back here if I can help it. And there's some more stuff. Let me turn on some light so we can see. Yeah. There's my stuff. And my books, and where I keep those bins. Yeah, I try not to let the dogs back here. Here's my water and food and stuff. I try not to let the dogs back here because I think that's unsafe. But it's the only place I could put that stuff. And here's my lamp that I've carried with me everywhere since we moved to Olympia. Right now, it's a pathetic shell of itself. It needs some repairs. And here's some drawers full of things. My wipes. And we head back out. So we head back out. I still got to do the dishes this morning, so ignore that. Coins for the laundry. My radio. My $400 radio. Yeah, things are still kind of in disarray. And this, of course, is where guests sleep. It needs a new cushion, but that comes later. There's the dog's new crate, because their old one won't fit in here.